Hey everybody, welcome back to the MacWhisper Academy. I'm Dylan Stewart, they call me the MacWhisperer. And if you're just getting started using Freeform, I'm wondering what you can do with it. Or maybe you just finished watching part one of this video series and you're excited about what's next, then this video was made just for you. The first you're hearing about Freeform and you're wondering yourself, what is this? You may want to stop for a second and watch part one of this video series. You can click right up here and get right to it. If you're new to Freeform, what you need to know is that Freeform was introduced by Apple last year as a part of the macOS 13 operating system and iPad and iOS 16. It's a brainstorming mind mapping app, allowing you to bring all of your ideas onto one screen and into one board so that you can get organized without jumping around to find all the separate pieces and notes and reminders and wherever else. Freeform is like Legos, and the only limitation is your own imagination, but like Legos, if we had no instruction booklets, we'd be lost. So the goal today is to give you some instruction booklets, some basic ideas to get you started. And if you stick around until the end of today's video, I'm going to share with you my best organizational tips. These tips are the ones I'm using to keep my Freeform boards organized, and I know they're going to help you as well. So stick around for that part of the lesson. And now without further ado, let's jump into Freeform. The first board I want to talk to you about is my dinner party board. Have you ever tried to plan a dinner party? It's super complicated. You've got guest lists and menus and seating charts and, oh my God, how do you put them all together? I'll tell you how, with a Freeform board. The first thing I had to start with was a guest list. So I went into my address book and I exported out the people I wanted to invite into an Excel spreadsheet, which I've added here in case I ever need to get their phone numbers or email addresses. As people have accepted my invitation, I've added them onto the guest list here. Then the next step is creating a seating chart. It was really easy to create this seating chart by just coming up here, grabbing myself a nice circle, and creating that as a table. Little tip for you, if you go to increase the size of a shape, it's really easy to get that shape accidentally out of shape. It becomes an oval, it becomes an egg, it becomes a whole big mess. But the trick is, if you hold your shift button down while you increase the size, like this, it'll increase perfectly evenly, keeping that circle a circle. Once you've got that, all you have to do is get yourself a couple of little squares. We'll move that over here. And go ahead and start to create the separate seats for each of the people. It's really simple to duplicate shapes by holding the Option button down on your keyboard, and that allows you to just drag and drop one after another of these and put the people's name on them and make it really simple. And then the next part of the dinner party was the menu. Once we decided on what we were going to serve and what the different pieces of the menu were going to be, I went ahead and grabbed the recipes right off the web so that when we're ready to cook, I don't have to go hunt around. Where did I put that bookmark? And did I save that? And is it in notes or is it over here? It's right here. And all I have to do is double click. That website opens up. I've got the ingredients. I've got the recipe. And I can make this amazing meal. And then there's one more piece that I added to this board that I think was kind of brilliant. And that is a link to the Weather Channel's website pointed directly to my address. This way, if I want to know what the weather's going to be on that day, I can double click here. It'll open it up into Safari and I can find out what the weather's like in case I need umbrellas or extra sunscreen. It just keeps it simple. And like I said, whether it's putting the Excel spreadsheet here or putting the Weather Channel link here or putting the recipes here, the purpose of Freeform is making it so that everything's in one place and you can see it all at the same time. My second example is a collaborative project that I'm working on with one of my clients. And so when we had our first call, there were all these questions and ideas and things we needed to get into. Rather than scratching them down on a piece of paper and then typing it back up, which just seemed like a waste of time. And rather than emailing each other back and forth and taking screenshots and making things crazy, I went ahead and built a freeform board and sent it to him. It's really easy to collaborate with someone by clicking the little share button here, and you can collaborate by sending them a link via email, via text, pretty much any way you want to connect with them. And when they accept that, the two of you can work on this board at the exact same time. So whenever Alex and I are working together, we're on this board, asking questions and moving ourselves forward in the process of building this membership for him. You'll see all sorts of questions and ideas and tips and tools and things we're talking about and answers. And one of my favorite parts about this board is that when Alex hired me, he hired me for a 3-month package. So it's my job to keep track of where we are in that process. But by putting each of the sessions on the right side here, and as soon as we complete a session, changing the color to purple, Alex immediately knows where we are and when it's time to send me another check. So it's a great way to collaborate and get organized and have all these ideas in one place where you can work together to build something amazing. Next up, let's talk about style and mood boards. Maybe you're looking to create a new style. In order to do that, you want to buy some shirts and some pants and some shoes and some glasses and whatever else, some accessories. It's really complicated to do that because it means you're taking a million screenshots, or you're printing things out regularly, or you're saving 1,000 bookmarks and trying to keep track of it, or adding them to notes or reminders or any one of these ideas. And it's always difficult because you can't see what you're actually looking for from any of those apps. Yeah, you can drag it into notes, but it's not gonna give you a good view of it. And it's certainly not gonna give you a good view of a lot of different pieces and allow you to mix and match easily. But Freeform will. Simply by going to the web and dragging the pictures that you're interested right off the web page onto here, you've got an easy board that can allow you to go, does this shirt go with those pants? Immediately you're saying to me, no, Dylan, it doesn't. In fact, nothing on this board goes with anything. And that's my style. You can even go ahead and drag a direct web link to a specific shirt or product right onto here so that double-clicking that will open up that website, let you buy it, and move on with your day. One of the other things that is related to these mood boards is hairstyles. For a lot of people, you'll go online and you'll screenshot, or you'll go into magazines and you'll tear out little pieces and you're like, oh, I like this hairstyle and I like that hairstyle, and what if I did this and what if I did that? And then you come to your hairstylist and you've got a bunch of screenshots on your phone and you're flipping through them and you're like, hold on, it's here, ignore that, that was somebody's menu, hold on, I know it's, wait, nope, went the wrong way, hold on. And it's really common for you to be scrambling to try to figure out where all those screenshots are. So why do it that way? Instead, I propose that we drop all of the different images and screenshots and even pictures you're taking from your phone directly into this board. If you find a magazine with a picture you like, you can click this link right here and you can take a photo right from your phone or scan the document and drop it right onto this board without having to grab scissors or tape. And then when you get to your hairstylist, instead of flipping through your phone and looking for screenshots, you can open Freeform right up on your phone and show them the board. Or you can go ahead and print it out. It's really easy to print it by coming up to the file menu and exporting it as a PDF or going to print. I prefer exporting as a PDF because when you get to print, it will sometimes make it several pages. So you wanna make sure if you wanna print just one page, click this little scale to fit button and it'll collapse it so it all prints out in a really easy way. And then I can come to my hairstylist and either show her the printout or show her the board on my phone. And I can say, hey, what do you think about these hairstyles? I really think they're cool. I really think they're great. I really like them. Do you think they'd look good on me? And she can turn to me and go, Dylan, you're still bald. Oh, good point. Next up, let's talk about flowcharts. I built this flowchart to show how my online ads are intended to bring audience members into becoming paying customers. and I used very simple shapes so that it was visual and easy for me to see the process of going from online ad to audience to email to training videos to paying customers or some other variation of this flow. Flowcharts are a great way to get a snapshot of information easily, and using Freeform, you can grab all sorts of things to create them, including specific web links, or maybe you want to put the actual text of your email right in the Freeform board, or the ad that you're doing and the picture you're using. You can really use it for any of that stuff. In my case, it was just a simple example of how I want the flow to go, but you can take that as deep as you want to go. And last up, let's talk about creating a vision board. I'm a Californian, so I'm a little woo-woo, and I've been creating vision boards since I was in high school. And every year around, you know, day after Christmas, somewhere around that range, I will go out and buy 50 magazines, and I'll sit on the floor with tape and scissors and glitter and God knows what else and try to put together this poster board of what I want my year to look like. I love planning my year out in advance and getting great ideas so that I can continue to build into a better and a better and a better life. But the problem with doing it that way is, first of all, it's a god-awful mess with little snippets of magazines. It's expensive. Magazines are not free, especially these days. And what am I supposed to do with that board? I can't really hang it on the wall. It's not really art-worthy. But if I just stick it in my closet, what was the point? By using Freeform, I can easily create a vision board, pulling things from all sorts of different places, websites or photos or images. I can create a basic to-do list. I can have links for some of the courses I want to purchase, or even just a little gift video that reminds me, but I've just got to dive right in. And then it's right on my phone, and it's right on my iPad, and it's right on my computer, and I can get to it from anywhere. And I can still print it out if I want to. And I hope this gives you some ideas about what's possible. And now's your opportunity. Drop back down in the comments section and toss in some other ideas now that we've had this conversation. Maybe you've got something popping in your head and you're like, oh my God, Dylan, you should have done this, or what about that, or how would I create this? I'd love to hear your questions and your suggestions. While you're down there, take a moment, hit that thumbs up button if you got value from this video. That allows other people to find this video easier and get the same level of help that you're getting by watching it now. Now let's talk about those organizational tips I promised you. First off, I want you to recognize this little sidebar that you see here, and it's automatically organizing the different boards you've got. The best thing on the sidebar is this favorites button. And this favorites button is so helpful because it means that you can really filter out the boards you're using regularly so you don't have to hunt through them. It's easy to add something to a favorite by just hovering over it and clicking the little heart button, and it's a favorite. One of the other pieces of organization, you'll notice up at the top, you can view this by icon or by list. The more boards you create, the more doing it by list is going to make sense and will allow you to organize it, not just chronologically, but by title. Also, don't overlook the search bar over here, because if you're looking for a specific something on a board, this is one of the fastest ways to figure out which board has that word or concept in it. And then you can jump right into it. So those are a couple of the tips, but really the best tip I've got is what you're going to see across the top here. You'll notice when I did this video, I didn't keep dropping back to the all boards section. I didn't open a board and then go back to all boards and open a board and go back to all boards. Instead, I went across the tabs at the top. It's very easy to open something in a tab by right clicking on it and just choosing open a new tab, and it will get added to the top. And you can move the tabs around into whatever order you want, or click the little X if you're done with that particular board. So when I'm doing a lot of work on Freeform across multiple boards, this is the easiest way for me to jump from my dinner party to my work with Alex to the different hairstyles I want, or my email flowchart. So that's today's lesson. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the MacWhisperer, and it's my passion and profession to help you get more done with your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And with that being said, I'll see you next time.